is we'll do a quick revision on what all we have done in this chapter so far. Okay, so from the beginning we'll see what all we have learnt in subtraction. So first we saw what was subtraction. So what's the meaning of subtraction? Subtraction means to take away, right? So we subtract a smaller number from a larger number. We always subtract a smaller number from a larger number. So the answer that you get when you subtract two numbers, the result is called as the difference. Okay, the result is called as difference. So subtraction is signified by the minus sign. So we saw how to do subtraction without regrouping first. So we have seen subtraction of two digit numbers in class 1. So then we learned how to do subtraction of, we again did subtraction of two digit numbers, correct? So here they have told subtract 14 from 56. So here we have, in the block form, we have 56 block here, okay? So we have 5 tens and 6 ones. From these 5 tens and 6 ones, we have to remove 1 ten and 4 ones. So if I strike out 1 ten here, how many tens will be left? 4 tens will be left. And in the from these 6 ones, I'll strike out 4 ones. So how many ones are left now? 2 ones. So 4 tens and 2 ones, which is 42. Okay, so without the blocks, how you can do? You can separately subtract ones and tens. So here ones we have 6 minus 4. So what you can do? You can take away 4 from 6. So when you take away 4 from 6, 2 will be left. Okay, same way after subtracting ones, we'll subtract tens. So when I'm subtracting tens, I'll subtract 5 minus 1. So how much is 5 minus 1? 5 minus 1 is 4. Okay, so 56 minus 14 is 42. Then we saw, let's see these examples that are there. Okay, so here they've told subtract by crossing out blocks as shown above. So 56 minus 35. So here we have 5 tens and 6 ones. So from these 5 tens, we have to remove how many tens? We have to remove 3 tens. So we'll strike out 3 tens here. Okay, so how many tens are left? We are left with 2 tens. And from the ones, we have to remove 5 ones. So these 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5. So when I take away 5 ones from 6, 1 is left, correct? So 1. So 56 minus 35 is 21. Same way now here, 69 minus 45. So I have 6 tens and 9 ones. From this, I will take away 4 tens and 5 ones. So first we'll take away 4 tens. So that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So when I do 6 minus 4, how many tens are left here? 2 tens are left. So we'll write 2 here. Now here from these 9 ones, I have to take away 5 ones. So this 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5. So how many ones are left? 4 ones are left. So 2 tens and 4 ones is how much? It is 24. So 69 minus 45 is 24. Okay, so this is how you do subtraction without regrouping. Then subtraction with regrouping. Now just like in addition, how you have carrying over, right? So when a number exceeds 9 in any place, we carry it over to the next place. Same way in subtraction, we do borrowing. Okay, in addition, regrouping is called as carrying over. In subtraction, it is known as borrowing. So here we saw subtraction of one digit number from a two digit number with borrowing. So here we did 27 minus 8. Now it will subtract ones column, 7 minus 8. But 7 is smaller than 8, correct? So we cannot take away 8 from 7. So what we'll do, we'll borrow 1 ten from the tens place. Now in tens place, we have 2 tens. So when I borrow 1 from tens, so how much will remain in tens place? 2 minus 1, 1 will remain, correct? So that 1 ten is equal to 10 ones. We know that. So that 10 ones plus 7 ones which are there here together becomes 17 ones. And 17 minus 8 is 9. Correct, 17 minus 8 is 9, and here in tens place we have 1, so 1. So 27 minus 8 is 19, right? So then we saw how to do subtraction of 3-digit numbers. So when you're subtracting 3-digit numbers, what you do? Always line up the ones, tens and hundreds, one below the other. So first let's do that. So 768 minus 53. So first we'll write 768. 7 in hundreds place, 6 in 10 and 8 in ones place. And then 53, 5 in tens place and 3 in ones place. Correct? Now we'll subtract the ones. So first we subtract the ones. So 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. So write 5 in the ones column. Then we subtract the tens, that is 6 minus 5. So when you do 6 minus 5, you get 1. Okay, so we'll write 1 in tens column. And then hundreds, we have only 7. So we'll write 7 as it is in the hundreds column. So 768 minus 53 is 715. So this was subtraction of 3-digit numbers without regrouping. Now, regrouping for subtracting the ones. So we'll do now subtraction by regrouping for subtracting only the ones place. I mean regrouping only the ones place. Okay. Now here they've told 352 minus 135. So we'll write, first we'll write the hundreds, tens and ones, one below the other. Then we'll subtract the ones. Now when you see ones, we have 2 minus 5. But we cannot take away 5 from 2. So we change 1 10 of 5 tens. Okay, we borrow 1 10 from 5 tens. So that 1 10 becomes 10 ones plus 2 ones is 12 ones, correct? So 12 minus 5 is 7. And in tens place now I have 5 minus 1, 4. Right, I am left with 5 minus 1, 4. So now 4 minus 3 is 1. So we'll write 1 in tens column. And in hundreds place I have 3 minus 1, which is 2. So we'll write 2 in hundreds column. So 352 minus 135 is 217. Alright, then 745 minus 462. Now first, line up the ones, tens and hundreds in their columns. So 745, 7 in hundreds place, 4 in tens and 5 in ones column. And 462, 4 in hundreds, 6 in tens and 2 in ones. Okay, so we are doing regrouping for subtracting the tens. Okay, so we are regrouping for tens now. Last we did for ones, now we are doing for tens. So first we subtract the ones. So 5 ones minus 2 ones. So 5 minus 2 is how much? It is 3. So we'll write 3 in the ones column. Then we'll subtract the tens. Now we cannot take away 6 tens from 4 tens. So what we'll do, we'll borrow 1 from 100. So in hundreds place we have 7 now. So I'll borrow 100 from 7. So 100 is equal to 10 tens, correct? 100 is equal to 10 tens. So 10 tens plus 4 tens gives us 14 tens. So 14 minus 6 when we do, we get 8. So we'll write 8 in tens column. Now I took I borrowed 100 from 7. So we are left with 7 minus 1, 6 here. So we'll subtract 6 minus 4, which is 2. So we write 2 in the hundreds column. Okay, we'll write 2 in the hundreds column. So 745 minus 462 is 283. Alright. Now. So then next we saw regrouping for subtracting both tens and ones. Alright, so here they've given us the example of 920 minus 248. So first, as usual, we'll write 920 and 248 in their respective columns. So 9 in hundreds, 2 in tens and 0 in ones, 2 from 248 in hundreds place, 4 in tens and 8 in ones column. Now there is 0 in the ones place, correct? We cannot take away 8 from 0. So what we do? We take 10 from tens place. So that 0 becomes 10 ones. So 10 minus 8 is how much? 10 minus 8 is 2. So we'll write 2 in the ones place. Then in tens place, I had 2. from which I took away 1. So 2 minus 1, 1. So 1 10 is left now. So but now I cannot take away 4 tens from 1 10, or 1 10 is smaller than 4 from 4 tens. So I cannot subtract. So what we'll do, we'll borrow 100 from the hundreds place. In hundreds place, I have 9. Correct? So I'll borrow 1 from 9. So 100 from 9. So 100 is equal to 10 tens. Right? So 10 plus 1 is 11. So tens place now we have 11 minus 4. So how much is 11 minus 4? It is 7. So we'll write 7 in the tens column. And then in hundreds place, since I took away 1 from 9, 8 is left. So 8 minus 2 is 6. So 920 minus 248 is 672. Okay, it is 672. Now, we learned how to check our answers, right? So, you can check your answers by doing the reverse process of addition. So, addition is called the reverse of subtraction, or subtraction is the reverse of addition, either ways. So here they have done 75 minus 36. So you can't do 5 minus 6. So they borrowed 1 from 6. So sorry, from the tens place, that is 7. So here 15 is there. So 15 minus 6 is 9. So we'll write 9 here. Then in tens place, 6 minus 3. So we'll write 3. So we got 39. Now to check the answer, what you'll do is you'll take the answer. Our answer here is 39. And from 75 and 36, we'll take the smallest number, which is 36, and add it to 39. So 39 plus 36. So here 9 plus 6 is 15. So when I do 9 plus 6, I get 15. So I'll write 5 and carry over 1 to tens place. So 1 plus 3 is 4, and 4 plus 3 is 7. So we got 75, which is the largest number over here. Correct. So when you add the answer and the smallest number, you get the largest number. So if you get that, it means your answer is correct. It means your answer is checked and verified. Alright, so this was what we have learned so far. Now in today's class, we will do number stories. So subtraction stories on page number 123 in your textbooks. Okay, so first one, they have done it for you. So let's see that. So there are 44 flowers in a garden. So there is a garden. In that garden, there are how many flowers? There are total 44 flowers. If 7 flowers are plucked, how many are left? Okay, from the 44 flowers, they are telling they plucked out 7 flowers. So now after plucking 7 flowers, how many flowers will be left in the garden? We have to find out. So, whenever they are asked how many are left, then what we'll do, we'll subtract. So, now, first we'll write 44 and 7 in columns. Okay, so for 1, 4 in tens and 1, 4 in ones. And we'll write 7 in ones column. Now, 4 minus 7 we cannot do, so we'll borrow 1 from tens place. So, when I borrow 1, this becomes 14. So, 14 minus 7 is 7, so we'll write 7 in ones column. Then in tens place, after I take away 1 from 4, 3 will be left. So 3 minus 0 is 3, so 3. So how many flowers are left in the garden? There are 37 flowers left in the garden now. Okay, so when you pluck 7 flowers from 44, there will be 37 flowers left. Alright, so that's the first problem. Now let's read the second problem. Samir has 62 pencils. Okay, he gives away 7 pencils. How many pencils are left? So they are telling Samir has how many pencils? He has 62 pencils. Okay, Samir had 62 pencils. So we'll write 62 first. 6 in tens place and 2 in ones place. Then from those 62 pencils, he gave away 7 pencils to somebody. So we'll write that 7 in ones place now. So how many pencils are left with him after he gave the 7 pencils? Let's find out, okay? So now we cannot do 2 minus 7. So what we'll do? We'll borrow 1 from 2. Okay, we'll borrow 1 from 6. So that becomes 5. Okay? And here in 1's place I have 12. So how much is 12 minus 7? 12 minus 7 will be 5. So we'll write 5 in 1's place. Now in 10's place I have 5 minus 0. So that will be 5 only. So 55. So Samir is left with 55 pencils. Okay, he is left with 55 pencils. Now, okay, so that was the second question. Next, there are 33 students in a class. 18 are girls. How many are boys? So there is a class of students. In that class, a total number of students is 33. Total number of students is 33. Okay, in that 33 students, 18 students are girls. So they are asking how many boys are there. So first we will write 33 here. Okay, 33. Then how many girls are there? There are 18 girls. So we'll write 1 and 8. Okay, so now to find the number of boys, we have to subtract 33 and 18. Now, first 1's place, 3 minus 8. We cannot do 3 minus 8. So what we'll do? We'll borrow 1 from the 10's place. So when I borrow 1, this becomes 13. So how much is 13 minus 8? 13 minus 8 is 5. Okay, 13 minus 8 is 5, so we'll write 5 in 1's column. Now in 10's place, since I borrowed 1 from 3, it becomes 2. So how much is 2 minus 1? 2 minus 1 is 1. So what is the answer we got? We got 15. So how many boys are there in the class? There are total 15 boys in the class. Okay, so 15 boys are there in the class. Next one. A man sells 5 oranges out of 24 oranges. How many are left? Okay, so a man is selling oranges and he has a total of how many oranges? He has total 24 oranges. Okay, he has total 24 oranges. So we'll write 2 in 10's place and 4 in 1's place. And from those 24 oranges, he sells how many oranges? He sold 5 oranges. So we'll write 5 in 1's place now. So we have to find how many are left with him. Okay, so we'll subtract the 1's plus 4 minus 5. So since we cannot do 4 minus 5, we will borrow 1 from 2. Okay, so this becomes 14. So how much is 14 minus 5? 14 minus 5 is 9. So we'll write 9 in 1's column. Then this 2 which is there in 10's place becomes 1 when I borrow it. So 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. Okay, 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. So that is 19. Okay, so 19 oranges are left with him. Then Ranjit has 25 balloons. 18 balloons burst. How many are left? Okay, so now Ranjit had 25 balloons with him. Okay, so 25 balloons with him. And from those 25 balloons, 18 balloons burst. Okay, 18 balloons burst. So you have to find how many are left. So you have to subtract 25 and 18 to see how many balloons were left. So to what you do, this answer you find out for homework. Okay, I've done so much. You'll calculate and tell the and write the answer over here. Now, sixth one. There are 74 mangoes on a tree. 28 mangoes are plucked. How many are left? So, how many mangoes are there in a tree? There are 74 mangoes in the tree. And from that, 28 mangoes are plucked. So, you have to find how many are left. So, you have to do 74 minus 28. Okay, when you do 74 minus 28, you'll get the answers of how many mangoes are left. So do question number 5 and question number 6 for your homework. Okay, so do question 5 and 6 for your homework. And try to do higher order thinking skills also for your homework. So they have told spot the errors and discuss why it may have happened. So there's some error in what they have done here, the calculations that they have done. So try to spot those errors and see why it may have happened. And they have told subtract 268 from 500 and check your answer. So do 500 minus 268 first. And the answer you get, that you add to 268 and see if you get 500 back. Okay, so do this for homework and we'll continue with the next chapter in the next class. All right, thank you.